So menorrhagia is essentially heavy menstrual periods. Periods, by definition, that last longer than 7 days or have more than 80 milliliters of blood flow over the course of your period. And it's a very common problem. Probably 10 to 20% of women throughout their lifetime have heavy periods that are difficult for them to deal with and may cause problems at work, may cause problems at home. Probably the most common cause would be what's called anovulation, which would be you're having cycles where your ovaries are supposed to be producing an egg each month, but for some reason does not release. That causes hormonal changes within the woman that causes the uterus to build up the lining to get thicker, and as that releases, it causes very heavy bleeding. Other causes that are concerning and why it's important to see your doctor is that you can have what's called hyperplasia or increased abnormal growth of cells or precancer cells that can also cause heavy bleeding. So there's a large variety of treatment options available for women, and that's something that's very nice is that they can look at a broad spectrum of options. Anywhere from the very simplest being birth control pills that people often take for contraception, and any type of birth control such as pills, patches, or rings can help control bleeding. IUDs, specifically the Mirena IUD, can help control bleeding. All of those can be reversible. There are longer term treatments, so it would be things like an endometrial ablation, where the inside lining of the uterus is treated in a variety of different ways to help decrease the bleeding. And then in more severe cases, may lead to hysterectomy and removal of the uterus to be able to help treat the bleeding. In a way, a lot of birth control pills are getting better. There's two new pills out that a lot of people heard of that are Yaz or Loestrin 24. Both have longer hormone cycles that thereby shorten periods, as well as birth control pills like Seasonique or Seasonal that go for 3 months and prevent people from having periods every month but go once every 3 months or less frequently. IUDs are not necessarily new but are more common now, and one IUD, Mirena IUD, that helps with bleeding has a progesterone that thins the lining. It can be placed very easily in clinic. And then the ablations are a lot of techniques that are being developed. HTA is one that we use in our clinic, that is the hot water that's circulated. The nice thing is that these things that used to be done just in the operating room and took a day out of work and a large copay are now done in the clinic for a smaller copay, easier recovery while the patient's awake, and then can go back home the same day. Then on top of that, as far as surgical procedures, there's more advances, and there are more and more surgeries such as laparoscopic hysterectomies or robotic hysterectomies that are also helping to give women more options when it comes to complete removal of the uterus. I think one of the biggest dividers is the person done with childbearing or not, because that really changes the treatment options that we have. The two treatment options we talked about surgically, the ablation and the hysterectomy, are things that can't be done if someone still wants to have children, because those, in essence, prevent childbearing from that point on. Some procedures are kind of split between the two. When you're trying to do a myomectomy or removing growths or polyps, those can be done both with people who are done with childbearing or before, when people still want to have children, to help them become pregnant, which sometimes prevent pregnancy. The birth control pills are available for everyone. Women think that this is something they should be embarrassed about, that they're sad because they're at work and they go through their pads and get their clothes bloody, they're at home and have a hard time getting out of the house to do routine things because they're concerned about the amount of bleeding they're having. And I want women to know that they don't need to be embarrassed about it, that there are treatment options available and they can come in and be seen and help to feel more comfortable in going out and doing their everyday routine.
For more information about this physician or to schedule an appointment, please call our referral line or visit notbiggerjustbetterhealth.com.